Welcome back to the workshop, everyone. Today we're going to be doing an unboxing of a kit that I will be doing a build of, and I can already hear the comment section, I thought you were going to build this one. I definitely am, but I haven't gotten to it yet, and this kit is now in stock at your favorite hobby retailer, so I wanted to give you a look at everything that will be in here, the instructions, the parts, the decals, all that stuff, so that you can go ahead and order it and then follow along with my build when I start building this up in a short amount of time. So this afternoon, we will be looking at AMT's 1/25th scale Dodge L700 truck. This is an all plastic kit. We've got vinyl and multimedia. It is the entire trailer, tire rack, and cab. And this one, of course, being the Dodge, is going to have the same cab as the A100 that I just built, or at least from what I'm seeing, they are extremely similar, if not the exact same cab. This is a nice looking vintage box art. Love that race team on there. Kind of looks like a Freddie Mercury back here. And then we got the guy with the beard and the sunglasses. So they always do such a nice job on that box art. You can see the detailing on the side. Lets us know we've got a 3-seat interior. And then the features of the kit will have a tilt nose. Looks like it's got the pogo stick back there on this one. We've got the nice tire rack, the flatbed, and even some ramps and the cool old style 5-spoke wheels. I forget what these are called right now, but those we will figure out. You'll let me know down in the comment section. So first up, let's look at the parts for the trailer. The trailer has this awesome wood grain to it, and it's very in scale with the size of the planks and everything. Then it's got the steel rails going down for support and then around the sides, and we've got the wood in the center. This looks a lot like the flatbed from the Ford delivery truck that I built. Looks very similar, the stake side truck that delivered the Coke machines and all that. Then we've got our ramps here. The ramps have a very nice expanded metal look to them. Not diamond plate, but expanded metal. And then the bottom of the trailer has the frame rails built in and the locators for the axles and everything else. You can see where the ramps will clip on with their little hooks at the bottom there. And then we've got the front of the trailer with our landing gear and whatnot. We'll be mounting everything. Also in the trailer package, we've got our axles, we've got our landing gear, we've got our wheels and our wheelbacks, all of our brake parts. It's great to see this entire tree not done in chrome. Now, the numerous wheels have fallen off the parts tree because they have a very thin connector, but don't worry, they're all there and they are really, really sharp looking. Very crisp, molded open. They are going to look great with some paint on them as we detail the model. We've got another parts tree here with more axles, wheels, brake parts. On this tree here, we've got a nice set of mud flaps, which actually have a checkered flag molded into them. Leaf springs, which would be typical for that trailer. Air tank. Be very careful. That's your jack for your landing gear. That's your handle. And then various, we got like our kingpin mount, various small parts on that tree for detail. We've got the front of the trailer, the tire rack area, smooth and riveted panels. We've got the sides with more wheel backs. We got a battery in there. We got the sides of the trailer. We can see for the rod that'll go across for the wheel rack. Riveted panels. Smooth on the opposite side. And some very basic steelies, which we'll be able to put on that rack because they have absolutely no use on this truck. But you get 6 of them there with backs. So think of all the stuff you could use those wheels on. These look just like the wheels that I built for the A100 that I just built. So that's very nice looking. Let's switch sides. We'll look at the multimedia stuff and then we'll come back and look at the tractor. Since this is a full in-depth unboxing, we will take a look at the manual next, what I call the paper goods and the multimedia site. We can see that everything builds up pretty standard. It is a V8. We've got our wheel assembly. It's not like there's any real options in this kit. The frame assembly is extensive, and it's kind of all crowded into one little page on there. We got all of our part numbers listed, and if you're ever wondering where the part numbers are, you can always reference the back of the box. You can see how they have the numbers in here. So if you can't recognize them, grab the back of the box and you'll see which frame rail is which. On a lot of that stuff, like these frame braces and supports and springs, I like to go in and use a sharp point Sharpie and mark those parts so that I don't really screw up bad. I always make mistakes, but I don't want to screw up too bad. So we've got our axle and differential. We just have one differential on this truck that's operational. And then we've got our frame with fifth wheel, radiator. They show you how to mount all that. Now, I'll be building all of mine together because it's a work truck. It's not a show truck. We've got our interior, three seats in there. It shows you where to drop the engine and your fuel tanks, mufflers. We go back to assembling the interior onto the cab, putting our glass in, doing the rest of the small mirror work. Check it out. Just like the A100, it's going to have opening doors. Now, you could make those work or not. Probably going to do them the same way I did with the A100, which is one is fixed and one is fixed open. I don't keep trying to move parts on my models because they always break. And then we've got the racing trailer parts that we just looked at. With our single axle, air tanks, you build your little box in frame for the rear axle. And then on the back, we've got our finer trailer assemblies. We've got our color callouts. So that's that. You could always pause the video so you can see what colors if you want to match the box art. How to install our wheel rack. And then final decal and paint guide. That's your beautiful instructions. Not as big as the other AMT semis. We've got a total of 10 because it is just a single axle truck and a single axle trailer. Beautiful Goodyear tires. And the molding on those is lovely. Strong, not too deep a tread, and the sidewalls look outstanding. Love them. We'll sand those down since they're so prominent. You can see them so well. You get 10 of those. They are a solid vinyl rubber. So you'll be able to insert your wheels when you're done. They are not hollow like the other ones we've seen. These are solid and they're very, very stiff, especially in a cool workshop like mine. We've got a nice decal sheet. By looking at that right away, you can see that none of the yellow is included, nor is the lower green. Just the stripes with the white pinstripes incorporated and our numbers. The rest will have to be masked and painted. Got our checkered flags, we got Goodyear logos, I am seeing no dash emblems on here, no gauges. Got our up and down stripes, beautiful Dodge Racing Team logos, all got that thin marker, that's going to look pretty nice, going to make it look lovely. You got all the different sponsor names, Driver, Kit Smith, Paint by Pearl Brothers, Race Customs Body, Quality Auto Parts, got the nice Dodge Racing Team logos. So if you wanted to custom paint your trailer, a lot of these would look really good. Powered by Dodge, Dodge Racing Team, Novi, Michigan, all that stuff would look pretty awesome on any other drag car too. We've got a clear parts tree, got our door glass if you want to use it, back glass, windshield, and headlights, all separate units. Nice and crystal clear. You can see my hands through there with no distortion. We've got some transparent red parts for our taillights and markers on the trailer. And then we've got a nice dainty chrome tree. Front bumper, windshield wipers, CB antenna, door handles, grab handles, marker lights. The marker lights have the lenses molded in, so just use an orange Sharpie. And we got our air horns and our headlight buckets. Very simple detailing. These must be for the taillights on the frame, I'm guessing. The chrome surrounds. And that's it for the multimedia side of the table. We're going to go over and look at all the cab parts now. diving into the cab, which is right here. And on the box art, we see that we're going to be having a tilt cab with opening doors as well. So that's going to be a lot of stuff to work on. We've got our radiator. We've got our cab mount right there with the hooks. We've got some sweet looking fenders. Those fenders are not mud flaps. They're actually right there on the kit. Got our cab sides. All the little rivets in there. Look at the molded in detail. And it's crisp. Given the age of this kit, it's nice to see a big Dodge truck release too. We got some wheel parts here, front and back, and our frame rails. So hopefully these areas here are all of our locators for our cross members. We've got plenty of holes molded in and bolt and rivet detail. So all these holes will be for tanks and accessory parts and other parts like the cross members and stuff like that. So it's always nice to see positive locations, I always call those, on the parts. On this one here are our mud flaps, and they do match the trailer's mud flaps. These spindles, does this mean it has steerable wheels as well? Ay caramba! Well, it's going to have those options in it. Make sure you're very careful when you snip the flash off of that. I wouldn't even use a hobby knife. I'd use your cutters, your snippers. Hobby knife, you might break that right off. Should be as open as that. So be very careful when working on that stuff. We got a little drive shaft there. We got some shock absorbers. We got cab pedals. So this will be an extensive, extensive build. We've got leaf spring packs, front and rear. We've got our big, large front axle. It's definitely steerable. Look at those tiny pins, so be very careful. Retrieval hooks, gear shift. What I'm glad to see is all this stuff is molded in white plastic, not chrome. Got our square fuel tanks, exhaust system, more cross members. We can see those large blocks. Those should be going in those areas on the frame. We got what looks like the pull handle for the cab tilt. Air tanks. More leaf springs, and the detail on those is nice. On this tree here, we've got our differential parts. We've got our seat backs, the three seats. This guy always gets kind of screwed. We've got more tanks. We've got the engine halves, manifolds, oil pan, intake, timing chain cover. We've got our steering link. A lot of stuff going on that parts tree. Here we've got our beautiful wheels, molded just as beautifully as they are on the trailer. I like that they're different. They're not the exact same. They're not reusing it. We've got our interior door panels. Going to be very basic detailing on those, but we'll do them. We'll paint them up. We've got some trees that are tangled here. We got a very similar dashboard to the A100. Valve covers, air cleaner, got our grill, which on this one is a white plastic piece, got our door hinge assemblies there and there, steering wheel of course. So we'll be doing a lot of hand detailing and painting. On this tree here, we've got our mirrors. I'm so glad these are on white plastic. Makes them much easier to glue together, especially with a door that's supposed to move. We've got our doors with little Dodge logos molded in to the front of each door. And what else we got going on over here? We've got our interior tub, completely different than the A100. You can see we got our tilting area, floors, we got our treaded steps. That whole cab is going to be able to tilt forward. We're going to have to build the hinges on that and everything. That is going to be a lot of stuff. The doors are going to be glued in place on mine. I'm not going to fiddle with that. I simply don't have the time, but I want you to know that it can be done. It's just going to take extensive fiddling and fettling. Beautiful cab. Very similar to the other one, just not a pickup truck. You can see all the nice little rivets around the back. Haven't seen a lot of flash on this kit. Given its age, I'm very surprised. Even the hinge mounting areas, which were somewhat closed off on the A100 telephone truck, are open on this one. So I won't have to be getting in here with a knife to reopen all that stuff. Excellent work on maintaining the molds. Got our nice Dodge logo across the front. Got our vents. So we'll be seeing a couple Dodges like this on the show this year at least, because of the A100 and this truck release. Now, stay tuned. We're going to be having some more builds coming up, as always, some more unboxings. We'll get some tools going on. And you guys have a great day. I will see you this weekend.